Hello students. Now today also I've come up with four questions, and these four questions are very, very important. And this four questions is from chapter 6, that is squares and square root. Now let's see what is there in question number 1. So in question number 1, express 49 as a sum of 7 odd numbers. That is, we have to express 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers. But this 7 odd numbers has to be consecutive. Now what is the most smallest odd number? The smallest odd number is 1. Now what is the next odd number? 3. The next is 5, 7, 9 and 11. How many odd numbers have we written? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now this is the next odd number. So altogether, how many odd numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you add up this all 7 consecutive odd numbers, you will get the answer as 49. So this type of marks will carry 2 marks, students. Okay. Now question number 2. How many numbers lie between the square of 12 and 13? That is, the question is, how many numbers lie between 12 square and 13 square? So what is the step that you can follow? You can follow the 12 square is what? 12 into 12, that is 144. And what is 13 square? 13 square is 13 into 13, that is 169. So after doing the square of 12 and 13, you will write, therefore, total numbers lies between 12 square and 13 square is equals to 169 minus 144. Put it inside the bracket and we'll do minus 1. Why minus 1? I will explain it. But first you subtract this one. This will give you 25, and then you have to subtract minus 1 and get the answer as 24. Now why we did minus 1? Now the reason is that when you start subtracting, suppose you have started subtracting for 144. So you don't count 144, isn't it? So you start, you're counting from 145, isn't it? So and 145, 146, 147, 148. So you will count up till what? 169, isn't it? So 145, 144, 145 to 169 is 25. But what is the question? The total numbers lies between. That means in between 169 and 144. So when you're counting from 145. But you're counting up till what? 169. So 169 is not included, isn't it? So the numbers has to be between 169 and 144. As because we have counted this 169 in this 25 numbers, so we'll subtract minus 1. So altogether 24 numbers are there in between 169 and 144, in which 144 and 169 is not included, students. Okay, so that is the reason I have subtracted minus 1. Fine, I hope all of you have understood. Now let's see question number 3. Now, question number 3 is, write a Pythagorean triplet whose one number is 14. Now, what is Pythagorean triplets? The triplets, the numbers which satisfies the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so Pythagorean triplets are, that is 2m, these are the numbers, m square plus 1 and m square minus 1. These are the 3 Pythagorean triplets. Okay, so if one of the number is given, so how to get it? So the first number, if one of the number is given 14, so this 14 has to be compared with 2m, that is 2m is equals to 14. Now get the value of m. So you have to transpose 2 to the right hand side, that is 14 divided by 2, it is m equals to 7. So now you know the value of m. Now you have to get the value of these two numbers. So what is m square plus 1? M square is 1 is 7 square plus 1. 7 square is 49 plus 1, that is 50. What is another number? M square minus 1. M square is minus 1 is 7 square minus 1, that is 49 minus 1, that is 48. So the triplets are, the one number was already given, 14. What is the other number? 48. And what is the other number? 50. So these are the triplets, Pythagorean triplets. Okay. So in the question paper, it will be always given that one number would be given. Fine. So when one number is given, you have to always compare that particular number with 2m. Okay, and you have to get the value of m. Once you get the value of m, you will get the next two numbers like this. Okay, now let's see what is there in question number 4. In question number 4, we have to find the square root of 100 by the method of repeated subtraction. Now, when it is written repeated subtraction, so how exactly we have to do? So every time we have to subtract with the odd numbers, okay, you have to remember this. So the first odd number is 1, so the answer will be 99. So what is the next odd number? It is 3. So if you subtract it, you will get the answer is 96. Now what is the next odd number? It is 5. So you will get the answer as 91. What is the next odd number? The next odd number is 7. So 7 would be what? It would be 84. Now what is the next odd number? It is 9. So it will be 75. Now what is the next odd number? It will be 11. So it will be 64. Now what is the next odd number? It is 13, isn't it? So it will be 51. Now 51, what is the next odd number? 15. So it will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It will be 6 and 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 36. Now what is the next odd number? The next odd number is 15, 17. So 17, this is 9, 1, 2, this is 19. And what is the next odd number? 19 only. So you will continue until and unless you are not getting 0. So how many times you have subtracted? Let us count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So the square root of 100 is 10. Understood? So this will carry 3 marks. Okay? So this understood. So be careful with the subtraction. Be careful with all the odd numbers. Okay? And if you see that you are not getting 0, that means somewhere you have done this subtraction is wrong. Might be the odd numbers you have placed it wrong. So please recheck it, okay? The main objective, you will start with 1 and you will continue until and unless you are not getting 0, right? And then you will count it how many times you have subtracted. That will be the required answer. So these are the 4 questions that you have to do in this session, okay? Thank you and take care of you.